have played with big stars like Michael Jackson,
sure,
Enrique Iglesias, from different styles.
Yes.
When you have to create a solo to a song from another artist, mm-hmm. how do you work it?
The interesting thing is that with those artists, like the big pop artists, mm-hmm. usually I would say 95% of the time, they want you to do what's on the record.
Okay.
So you don't have a lot of creative freedom in those situations. Oh. But occasionally, you know, Justin Timberlake had a couple of situations where he would want me to do my thing. And it's a balance. It's a balancing act between what you want and what they're looking for. So the best thing for me to do is really try to get inside their head. Mm-hmm. Imagine that I'm them. What are they really asking for? Because sometimes they're not guitar players. They don't know how to ask.
And how to tell you.
How to say it, right. But after a while, you sort of get a sense of what they're looking for. They might say, they might mention another song or another part of a song. Can you give me something that's kind of like blah, 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 blah? And then, mm-hmm. then I know, okay, I know what they want. They want me to, they want this funk rhythm thing, or they want a shred lead, or they want a bendy, you know, textural thing. And then I'll go make adjustments and try to dial into that mindset. But I don't know if there's ever you're asking, is there, what's the process? I think the process is different every time, mm-hmm. you know.
You adapt.
Exactly.
Talking about composition and your own songs.
Mm-hmm.
Have you got a method, or a song can start from different forms, points, yeah. from rhythm, guitar,
exactly.
from a melody?
Right. And it's a really good question, and it's amazing that after all these years, I still don't have. I wish I had a method. I'd probably make $20 million, but it's anything. I guess the main thing for me is to find a way to get in the zone of inspiration. So I could write a song right here, make it work, mm-hmm. you know, but to believe in it, it has to be from inspiration. Mm-hmm. So the first thing that has to happen is I have to either be inspired, or if I'm not inspired, I have to figure out a way to get inspired. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that's just listening to music. I'll just put headphones on and listen to a bunch of different music. Sometimes I can get inspired by watching a cool movie. I can get inspired by playing a different instrument, like playing around on keyboards, and suddenly there's different voicings that I don't normally. I might find some cool thing. I'm not a very good keyboard player, but I can use that as an inspiration tool. A lot of times I'll sequence a drum groove, or find a library of drum grooves, and there might be a unique drum thing that triggers an idea. I'll do whatever it takes to get inspired, but I don't like to write songs by forcing mm-hmm. it. I like to just get myself in a mindset where something comes over me.
A good idea for
right.
work
exactly.
on it.
Right. So unfortunately, I don't have. It's always different. And what really is the most uncomfortable part of it for me is that usually the best song ideas come to me when I'm nowhere near a guitar, nowhere near the studio. So I'm driving, or I'm walking down the street.
How do you remember that idea?
Sometimes I'll grab my phone and I'll hum
technology.
The melody. Yeah, the technology helps because that's a really good point. In the old days, there was a lot of times I would have an idea and I would try to remember it, and by the time I get home, it's gone. Yeah. You know,
many great songs
have been lost? They're just floating around somewhere.
Floating around somewhere.
Right.
I consider you a master of improv.
Wow, thank you.
There are not many guitarists that can play shred, metal, rock, and can improvise like you. So, how do you work improvisation?
Yeah, it's a very flattering question because a lot of the things that you are saying in the question are things that I still struggle with
okay.
in my own mind. I appreciate it. I always feel like I see so many great musicians who seem to have a very easy, natural, improvisational demeanor, and mm-hmm. that's something that I always feel like. I feel like when I improvise, I get close sometimes to what I want to be saying, but very seldom do I hit the mark. Mm-hmm. So it's
like internal.
It's always searching. Something. Yeah, always. Right. I still feel.
But art is, I think.
That's true. Right. Improvisation also is a. It's deeper than we think it is because improvisation really happens here. Mm. So having a spontaneous guitar solo that you improvise is a two-step thing because one is here. And then the second step is that's instantly translated. Your fingers are instantly.
In real time.
In real time, right. So on a lot of times on albums, I'm improvising sometimes, but it's happening in my mind. So I'll hear something, I'll go, oh, this should go. And then I'll find it mm-hmm. on the guitar. And so in a way, some people might say, well, that's not really improvising. But it is improvising, it's just not. It's not doing the real-time mm-hmm. thing.
Process, but
the real-time process,
here
right?
Here,
right,
is real improvising.
Exactly, because what's not improvising is having a bunch of ready-made licks mm-hmm. that you just sort of paste over a song.
90% of guitarists, including me,
a lot of us do that, and I rely on that too, especially if I'm not feeling inspired. So okay.
You use that tool in that moment.
Of course,
you are not inspired, but.
Of course, yeah. And on some level, Scott Henderson has talked about this. On some level, what improvisation on guitar really is the instantaneous decision to place rehearsed ideas mm-hmm. somewhere.
Ah, okay. Things that you have played in
right.
the past, but
in a new place.
In a new place,
exactly.
In the right
That's
the
exactly
right, moment.
Right, because you and I are improvising right now. Mm-hmm. With language and with a different kind of language, and even though I've said all these words before, I've used many of these sentences before, mm-hmm. it's still a brand new. We're creating a brand new conversation, so in a certain way, I think it can be helpful to think of improvisation on an instrument that way as well.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You are, for me, one of the greats.
I appreciate it.
It's a honor to me and a dream come true, as I told you before. Muchas gracias a ustedes. Espero que disfruten de este momento único de tener a uno de los mejores del mundo en nuestro canal Tus Clases de Guitarra. Los veo entonces en el próximo tutorial. Thank you.
A dream come true is this.
This guy.
Thank you, Ajay.
I just got a free guitar lesson. Thank you so much. I just got a free guitar lesson. I appreciate it.
No,
he's great.